Hello guys, Bud here with Dependable Lawn Care, and I wanted to show you guys my, I guess we'll call this the 2019 leaf season cleanup setup. So I actually have two different setups, and I'll kind of go over those real quick. Won't spend a whole lot of time, we're just kind of waiting for it to warm up enough that we can get started for the day. So what I've been doing with my primary trailer, I have my FW15 up in front with the bagging system on it, and then my 61-inch Z3X and my 52-inch Z3X. The Z3X mowers have the quick shoot blocks on them, so really like these things. They're super easy to use. Forward is open, back is closed, and then you can even have it part way open like that if you want. Which sometimes does kind of help out when you're still trying to mulch up the leaves, but you just want to fan it out a little bit. So on top of the quick shoots, we are also running this season X-Blades. And I kind of have my version of it. I did purchase the little Ballard brackets, and all those do. So this is my X-Blade setup right here. I've got my standard cutting blade, which is just like a medium lift blade. And then on top of that, I have, it's actually a Skag mulching blade. And I've talked about that in previous videos. I went with that because of the height of the lift. It'll fit with the factory baffles right here. These little baffle plates, which I want on because I want to get as much mulching action in there as I can get. So those little Ballard X-Blade kits or whatever, all they do, it's a little metal plate that goes between the two blades, like a washer, but it has shoulders that keep the blades just like this. So in other words, the blades can't turn on the bolt and end up like that. You know, they actually have to stay in an X pattern. So we're running the X-Blades on both of the Z3X mowers, and what this setup is primarily just a mulching setup. We're not collecting leaves with this setup, we're just mulching. The backpack blowers be the same for both setups. Have the 570 Husqvarna 570 BTS and the Husqvarna 580 BTS. The 580 is, I believe, 3 seasons old now. The 570 is going into its second season. Equally love both of these blowers. If you're going to go out and buy one, if you're thinking about purchasing one, honestly, our next purchase will probably be another 570, simply because you get just as much work and output out of that 570, but it's just a little bit quieter and a little bit lighter than the 580. And I'm not bashing the 580 at all, it's a beast. But between the two, you know, running them side by side, you can't hardly tell the difference between the two as far as what you get done, okay? And that's kind of the bottom line, is what you can accomplish with it. Now you notice the tip on the 570 is just smoothed off. And then on the 580, it has like a flared tip. I've heard a couple guys say that changing that tip makes a big difference. So I've actually got, $15 for a tip, like the 570, and they're interchangeable. So I am gonna get that tip to put on the 580 and see if maybe it's moving more leaves than the 570 at that point. But right now they're pretty well neck and neck. So those blowers will either be in this trailer or they'll be in the other trailer, depending on what setup we're using. So that's this setup. It's pretty basic. It's basically just my primary mowing setup, with the exception of, you know, having the X-Blades to mulch the leaves better. Another tool that I can take with either setup, because it's going to go in the back of the truck, is my Husqvarna 350 backpack blower. And this kit, so let me get on there so you can see the part number and the pieces. This was a very inexpensive adapter kit for cleaning gutters that I got off of Amazon, and all the sections screw together, and then you have the elbow tip to reach down into the gutter so you can blow them out. I can unscrew the sections and take them apart, shorten it. I could actually get another kit and lengthen it if I wanted to, but with my backpack blower, and by the way, this will go on the 350 BT. I believe it'll go on the 150. It'll also go on the 125 handheld blowers. It comes with another elbow that directs it up when you come out of the handheld blowers. So anyway, the kit itself is 11 feet, and then there's about an additional 3 or 4 feet on the blower tube on the 350. So I have the potential of reaching the 11 plus, we'll just say 3, so 14 feet, plus you're wearing that backpack blower at waist height, so that's another 3 feet. So a lot of the houses around my area are these split level houses where it's one story in the front and two in the back, and I think I'll be able to reach that second story on most of those houses. And what I'm trying to avoid is having to carry around a ladder and getting on and off a ladder. If I can do it all from the ground, it's safer and less equipment that I have to carry around, and it's safer and it's safer. I'm not a big fan of ladders after I broke my foot a few years ago. So that's that setup. Then on the open trailer, I have the John Deere 920 with the Protero on it. And you guys have seen this. You guys have seen this system in action. And if you haven't, go back and watch the videos from last year on our leaf cleanup setup. So this is the system, or the setup, that I'll use when I'm actually collecting and removing the leaves from the property. A lot of properties, they're fine with me mulching up the leaves. It mulches them up until they're just practically dust, and they're fine for the lawn, and we can leave them just like that. And then the ones that that really want us to collect them, that's their preference. Sometimes we do have properties where the leaves are too thick, and even after you mulch them up, they're still just too thick. And so for those kind of properties also, we have this setup where we can actually, typically we mulch up the leaves first just to condense the amount of leaves that we have to haul off. And this is a dump from the seat, 14 bushel, I believe. It could be 13, but 13 or 14 bushel clamshell hopper from Protero. Been really happy with this unit. Thing is tough and dependable. You don't have another motor to deal with like you do with a pull behind type vacuum unit. So that's that setup. And basically what we do is we put a tarp down on the trailer, we back up on the trailer, dump the leaves, and kind of do that in layers as we move forward on the trailer so that we don't have as much weight to drag off, because this is not a dump trailer. So when we get to the dump, we can just drag those tarps off one at a time, and it's not a whole lot of weight, and it unloads pretty quick. The only downside to this system is that once you get the trailer about half full or so, you can no longer put the mower on it. So what we end up doing a lot of times is we'll get 1 or 2 yards on a trailer, which works nice on the neighborhoods where we have several houses in a row. And then we have to leave the mower on site. You know, we take the key, park it kind of out of sight, out of mind, and we'll go dump the trailer, come back, pick up the mower, move on to the next one, or the next 2 or 3. And so that's that setup. And as I said, along with the 570 and the 580 Husqvarna backpack blowers, which right now we just set them on the trailer or in the back of the truck and unload them when we get there. I'm probably going to go ahead and invest in some backpack blower racks, just to make that a little bit more efficient. And then in the back of my truck, I have a hedge trimmer. So my Husqvarna, I can't ever remember what it is. 525 HF 3S. It's a lot of digits to remember. Anyways, my pole hedge trimmer, because we do have at least one property I know of today that she wants us to go ahead and trim up the shrubs in the front. And we can just blow all that out after we trim it up and bag it right up. So that'll work out pretty nice. Fuel cans, backpack blowers, all the tarps that we use. I have some canvas tarps, and then I have just some heavy duty regular tarps, and they're all in that toolbox on the front of the trailer, along with a spare belt or two for the mower and the Protero, you know, any kind of spare parts I would need out in the field. So try to have everything we need when we go out, so we don't have to stop or have very much downtime if something does give out on us. But so far, the Protero system and that John Deere 920, they've both been really good on belts. I don't think I've replaced a belt on either one, as far as the deck belt or the drive belt for the Protero. So that's that setup. And I'll also be bringing along my 350 BT with the gutter cleaner on it. And all I'll do is just unscrew that, so I've got, you know, two or three pieces to deal with instead of the whole long thing, and just put that in the bed of the truck. So anyway, I'll try to get some video for you guys, some of this stuff in action. I mean, you've already seen the mowers with the X blades in action. You've already seen the Protero in action. So, you know, I want to get some video with this dude using it if I can. And other than that, guys, that's about it. I just wanted to kind of show you what we're rolling with this year. Oh, one other thing. So I've got the Rackham. Grass catchers, and I did a video on the bag that I made, the tarp bag, to extend those. Now, I'm not putting that system into use yet, simply because I only have one bag made and I need to make more of those bags. But as I said in that video, this is kind of my backup system for the Protero. If something were to break down with that, or the mower itself broke down, then I can use my Ferris mowers with these grass catchers and the tarp bags as soon as I make more of those. And then I'll have a backup system to be able to keep going. So I am going to go ahead and make some more of those bags and kind of have that ready. I think I'm probably going to make about a dozen bags is what I'm thinking right now. So that would be right now a backup system. If and when I start using that, if it's more efficient and you know, easier to use, you know, whatever, than the Protero system, then I might use that primarily, and just you know, keep one or the other as a backup. But it's always good to have a backup, have some redundancy. So that's the two setups, guys. I've got the collection setup and just the plain mulching setup. So that's what we're working with this year. That's what we're rolling with. And right now, that does everything we need to do without having to spend a lot of money on a big vacuum system and a dump trailer and all of that. You know, I may go that route someday, some year, but for right now, there's really no reason to do that, because this is getting the job done, making money, and that's really what it's all about, is you know, getting things done efficiently and making money at it. So anyway, it's about time for us to go get to it. So I'm going to finish loading up. And as always, guys, thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Get out there and make some money, and we'll catch you on the next one.